Okay, Duke, for the moment, thanks very much indeed. Disappointing night then for Mark Reynolds, but we've seen a pretty good champion here in action. And of course, we have another title bout coming up just a little later in the evening. But before that, we have a few Christmas presents to hand out, because those regular viewers of Ringside on the Road, those of you who've entered our competition, well, we have eight British Boxing Board of Control handbooks to give away. That was the question that we asked you. Frank Bruno beat Oliver McCall to win the WBC World Heavyweight title at Wembley. Which other British fighter contested a world heavyweight title in 1995? Well, the answer, of course, was Herbie Hyde. He took on Riddick Bowe in a WBO title clash in March, Bowe stopping Herbie in round six. And there you are, the names of those who've won those yearbooks you've seen through on the bottom of your screen. Congratulations to those of you who've won. Commiserations if you didn't. Now then, of course, we have, so many mouth-watering events coming up during the course of the weekend. But the main course, well, that comes in the early hours of Sunday morning when Mike Tyson, of course, back in the ring again. He takes on Buster Mathis Jr. Ian Dark and Glenn McCrory, they're not here this evening. The reason for that, of course, is that they're out in Philadelphia.
Well, if you think it's been cold in London, let me tell you, it's absolutely freezing here in Philadelphia. Thank goodness the fight is indoors. Mike Tyson has been getting himself ready. A Tyson fight is always a happening. I'm looking forward to it. How about you, Glenn?
I'm looking forward to it. I think it's the first time we're really going to see Mike, the McNeely-Foes fiasco. This is a real fight.
We've seen both of the fighters at the weigh-in, and how did you think they looked?
Tyson looked fantastic. He looks in tremendous shape at this present moment. Mathis, he's not in the same sort of physical shape as Tyson, but he's still good. He's prepared for this fight for a long time.
And, of course, Frank Bruno is going to be here at ringside. Really, it's a kind of test, really, for Tyson. How good can he look with these title fights coming up next year? They've got it all planned. Bruno in March, Seldon for the WBA title in June.
Well, I think in Tyson's own mind, he needs to have a good fight. He needs to impress, because he needs to get his confidence, especially for a fight which is a tough fight. Bruno is a tough fight for him. The camp know it's tough, so he needs to impress.
Are we writing off Buster Mathis here, I wonder, a bit? He went four rounds with Riddick Bowe. He can box a little bit. He's not a puncher, but he is unbeaten.
He's unbeaten, and we've always got to look at that. He is unbeaten, so we don't really know how good he is. It's the biggest opportunity of his life. He's going to pull something extra out. He's got to.
Incidentally, we're talking to you here from the Philadelphia Art Museum. Now, this and these steps here behind us is where Sylvester Stallone did his famous training run in the Rocky film. Now then, Glenn, did you ever do any training on this kind of thing?
Not quite like this, but there's something I've got to do while I'm here. Got to do it.
We all wanted to see Ian Dark do it as well, but absolutely no chance. Don't forget, midnight, we're on the air with coverage of that Tyson fight, midnight tomorrow, but plenty of action to come before then. Of course, tonight, Willie Perdomo against the Irishman Vince Feeney still to come. But right now in the ring, we have a super bantamweight fight. It's four rounds, 3 minutes each, of course, between Pat Mullings from Harrow and Birmingham's Peter Buckley. Let's join our MC, John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is in the super bantamweight division and sponsored by the Sunday Express. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you, fighting out of the blue corner and wearing the white trunks, he's from Birmingham, the former two-time Midland area champion. Would you please welcome Peter Buckley? And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner and wearing the black trunks. He's from Harrow with an undefeated professional record. Would you please welcome Patrick Mullins? At the weigh-in yesterday, Buckley scaled at 8 stone and 13 pounds. Mullins, 9 stone and 3/4 pounds. Your referee is star referee Larry O'Connell. Your timekeeper is Mr. Michael McCann. And this is 4 3-minute rounds of boxing.
And your commentators once again are Nicky Piper and Barry McGuigan.
4 3-minute rounds. I've always wanted to have a look at this young Patrick Mullings, trained by Dean Powell down in the Peacock Gym. And he's facing one of the most experienced pros in the country, and Peter Buckley here in the white shorts. Mullings in the black shorts. Attacking southpaw, as you can see. likes to put the pressure on.
Well, we've all seen Buckley many times in the ring on Sky Sports. He's very experienced. Was the first man to go the distance with Nazim Hamed, Barry?
Yeah, one of the only guys in this country to go the distance with him, and he's a tough cookie in the fight. He had a second fight with him and it was stopped, and he thought prematurely, and I think most of the ringsiders, the boxing fraternity, thought it was too. So it's a tough and difficult fight for Patrick Mullins, but it's the sort of guy he's going to have to beat if he wants to get to the top. As you can see, southpaw, right-hand lead, likes to come forward, but Buckley can handle most of these guys. He weighed 9 stone last night, but he really is a super bantamweight. Wants to fight campaign at the super bantamweight division. Buckley weighed just inside 9 stone, 8'13".
Good upper body movement from Patrick Mullins. He's seems to be a well-balanced fighter, good combination punches.
Yeah, good jab too. He's pretty short, but he likes to, as I say, crowd his opponents and throw lots of punches from different angles. He's really a puncher. Out of his 5 wins, only one has come inside the distance. And if that's the case, Buckley will have nothing to worry about, because he's fought some of the best punchers around and handled them. So he's not going to have that to worry about with Mullins. But he's going to have to cope with his pressure. And he's doing that quite effectively in this round, throwing lots of punches. Impressive start from him.
Cole Mullings with a good right hand did Buckley there. Buckley is again one of these fighters who really is much better than his record suggests and could win a lot of fights. I think he chooses not to, otherwise, because he won't get as much work otherwise if he wins them.
Probably right. Yeah, he likes to fight at least once a week, this guy. He's in 1 year he had 16 professional fights. He really is busy. Likes to fight as often as possible. From the Nobby Nobbs stable in Birmingham, managed by Nobby Nobbs and trained by him. Buckley is a young man, he's only 26 years old, but this is his 78th professional fight, and completely unscathed, not a mark on him. This young man, Patrick Mullins, very impressive opening round. Here's the Patrick Mullins corner. Dean Powell facing him in the black top, one of the best. He's obviously very happy with his opening round against the experienced Peter Buckley.
Round two.
Was the opening round was definitely young Mullins, wouldn't you agree? Nice snappy jab from him there as well.
I personally wouldn't, Barry. I think he got through with a few punches early on, but Buckley is starting to land more. Depends how much Buckley wants it tonight. He's turned in some great performances in the past, but again gets through with a cuffing right hand.
But he has a lazy attitude, and his work ethic is not good. He just does enough to stay in there and be competent. Competitive, but
very lazy. But if you watch, Mullings threw 4 punches which all missed there, and he's well out of distance again, missed with 2 more. Whereas Buckley got through with that right hand,
indeed. Referee Larry O'Connell doesn't have much to do here, these guys are just keeping it at a distance. But again, you see, Mullins doing the pressurising.
I haven't given him a scoring shot yet, though, Barry. He's fallen short with everything, and then gets caught with two good left hooks. Again, that right, that left cross, I should say, from the southpaw Stan Smith. Good right lead.
Peter Buckley, a very experienced guy, knows how to tuck up, knows how to survive, as I said, completely unmarked. But lacks the desire, Nicky, doesn't it?
Certainly does. Does there, yes, he's just covering, coming back from nothing himself when we know he can.
Has won the Central Area Super Featherweight title, and he is one of the better super bantamweights in the country, but as I say, lacks desire, lacks a little bit of appetite for winning, and has sort of slowly fallen into the trial horse attitude. You know, he just doesn't seem to have a... You see it there, he was competing very well in the early part of the round, but yeah, happy to just throw a few punches and make Mullins miss.
Exactly, he's falling behind again now.
Mullins doesn't like to back up, doesn't fight effectively coming back, going back. He likes to take the fight to his opponent. What Buckley's got to do is just got to step on the gas a little bit, put a little bit more pressure on. Mullins has a very impressive amateur record, won the ABA bantamweight, and competed top level as an amateur. Welcome back to Your Call. Here's Vince Feely. It's the biggest night of his life. Young bantamweight from County Sligo in Ireland. Working away with his trainer, Colin Wilson, for the biggest night of his life. WBC International bantamweight title coming up later on. Don't forget and watch that. Coming off after this fight, round three. Patrick Mullins, black shorts against Peter Buckley in the white shorts. Buckley's 78th professional fight and Mullins is 6th professional fight. So, great deal of difference in experience. But Mullins, I feel, is doing pretty well. And he won the last round again. But Nicky will probably disagree with
him. No, I won't. Not always, Barry. It's a funny round. If you probably look back on video and recount the scored punches, Buckley would have had just as many as Mullins. But as you say, he was going backwards. And the second half of the fight, Mullings came forward, got in distance and started throwing those combinations, as he's doing now. At this stage in Mullings' career, I feel Buckley has the ability to win this. Good right hand.
Well, I've seen him do this several times. He's a frustrating guy to watch because he's shown tremendous ability in the past. As I say, seems to lack the appetite for winning, you know? Not lack the appetite for the game. He wouldn't have had 78 professional fights if that were the case, but he's got a bit of a loser's mentality, unfortunately. However, he's a very competent guy and has mixed with the best in the world, and that's no question of a doubt. Mullins, a good right hook to the body from the southpaw stance. Again, slowly applying the pressure here and getting through with, getting a little bit more audacious and a little bit more daring. Better work for him, picking the shots well.
Hooking well now, isn't he? He's starting to move in, getting a bit closer and looking for these shots.
Good shots to the body from Mullins, just picking those right hooks into the solar plexus of Peter Buckley. Buckley needs to step up a gear. He needs to start throwing a few more punches. Oh, good uppercut on the inside, but again, admiring his work and not doing enough of it.
That's right, Mullings' defence is a little weak at the moment. But he's clearly winning this round. Good work.
Mullings really has to sort of settle down into the professional game. He's only learning that this is only his sixth professional fight, so he's a lot of things to pick up. But he's going to pick him up boxing a guy like Peter Buckley. Mullings is 25 years old. He's not a chicken for the. He's no chicken for the bantamweight division, super bantamweight. He's relatively old. Welcome back to Your Call. Main event coming up next. This is the champion, WBC International Bantamweight champion, Willie Padermo from the Dominican Republic, based in Spain, making his first defense here tonight, very shortly, against Vince Feeney from Sligo. It's the fourth and final round. Patrick Mullins in the black shorts against Peter Buckley in the white shorts. And they have Mullins comfortably ahead, but Peter Buckley has shown that he can fight on even terms with this guy, just hasn't worked hard enough.
Impressive work now from Mullings. Last round, he's still very fit, must put everything into it, and he knows it. He's comfortably ahead.
I've spoken to Dean Powell, Mullins' trainer. He said this guy has got real potential. He needs to be a little bit more disciplined, but obviously he's got great potential and showed that as an amateur. And he hopes that it will transcend into the professional game and that he can make that transition. This is a good performance. Again, as I've seen it many times in the past, Buckley really lacking a little bit of an appetite for the game, just didn't really seem to have an awful lot of desire left. And he's getting picked apart here and making Mullins miss and not capitalise on that. Pretty right uppercut, but again, one punch and he should be throwing them in bunches.
Yeah, he's using that cross guard, isn't he? Seems to be more interested in defence than attack. But again, he's giving a very good prospect, a good workout, a good experience. And I suppose that's what the promoters like about him. Good left hook, though.
Yeah, good shot to the head, but Mullins comes right back. Buckley looks a bit tired at this stage, a little bit listless. His head's coming up, flat-footed, taking a few shots now. It's not like him to take full-blooded punches, but there was a couple of good shots from Mullings.
Good right hook from Buckley, but Mullings is getting through with the majority of the hooks.
And again, Buckley looking for one punch instead of throwing them in bunches. It's as if it's a sparring session for him. He's just sort of taking his time. No urgency attached to his work at all, and that's what he needs. Again, the quantity of punches coming from Mullins. Last 15 seconds of round four. It's been all Mullins in this round.
Seems to get hit and then retaliate with about 5-10 shots of his own. Good left hook, though.
Good left hook right on the belt. Yeah, that was a comfortable win for this young man, Patrick Mullins. goes on to win number six, but wasn't able to get rid of the tough, always tough, Peter Buckley. What did you think of that performance, Nicky?
Well, it was a fairly good performance from a young prospect, very inexperienced. He showed his inexperience, but he also showed his potential. And Dean Powell, very successful camp at the moment with a couple of Commonwealth champions and a few other champions. And he's in the right camp to get further in his career.
No doubt about it. I think this Dean Powell's one of the best trainers in the country, and this young kid's got tremendous ability. Let's hear what the MC's got to say.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Larry O'Connell's scorecard reads for Buckley 38.5 points, for Mullings of 40 points. Your winner and still undefeated, Patrick Mullings.
6 out of 6 then for Patrick Mullings, beating Peter Buckley. Duke McKenzie, how much will he have learned from a fight like that?
He would have learned plenty, I'd have thought. The fight went the distance. Buckley was always in there, you know. I don't think he was ever going to win the fight, but he was always in there. Caught Mullings once or twice, caught him with, some nice counter punches. Mullings was always like the governor, if you know what I mean. He was always the guy that was on top, landing the better punches, the cleaner shots, and just, dropped the pace and up the pace as and when he really wanted to.
Buckley's become a bit of a professional loser, but you actually fought him a couple of times, didn't you?
Yeah, actually, we did, earlier on in my career as an old sparring partner of mine. We boxed a couple of times, as you say, but Peter's had a lot of fights and he's a very experienced campaigner and will give anybody a decent fight.